Hi guys, and welcome to this little explanation video on the profitability dashboard. What I want to do in the next couple of minutes is walk you through the individual customization steps in order to make sure that you're able to tailor this template to your specific business needs. So what I'm going to be doing is walk you through these steps down here and make sure that you're able to change all these settings within the template. So first and foremost, if English is not the language you're using on your computer in terms of the regional settings, you need to change the months in the sheet mapping. What do I mean by that? So let's quickly look at the sheet mapping. And what I mean by that is you need to change these months over here. So in my particular example, say I will go ahead, enter the first 2 months. And if you know the autofill functionality, you just select these first 2 months in your own regional settings and you drag it down. So since my computer is set to English, it of course updates the months in the English language. So we got Jan, Feb, March, and so on and so forth. So the next thing we would need to do then is make sure that these months are also accurately reflected in our data pool. The pre-filled data pool that you receive with this template actually includes all of the months in the English language. So you would have to change these values as well. Let's quickly take a look at them. You see down here, you got all the months in English. So if you were to update this with other regional language settings, you would also have to change these months over here. So the best way to do this would be if you wanted to use this pre-filled data pool, is if you use the search replace functionality. You would select column A, click Control F, and with the find and replace functionality, you'd be able to replace Jan with whatever other word you have in your language. Okay, so this is the first and most important step. From here on, it gets easier, I promise. So let's go back to the introduction sheet. What we need to do next is make sure that we bring in the right products on the sheet mapping. On the mapping sheet, you'll find this section in column D. Please leave all gray cells untouched because we need them for the drop-down lists to work properly. What you can do is use this green area to bring in whatever categories or products that you're using. You see quite a lot of room to put these products in here. Now the pre-filled data set features 4 categories: chairs, tables, kitchen, and accessories. Why do we need to bring these in? In the different sheets, so let's look at the by product and country sheet, you'll be able to change the selected product categories with the help of a drop-down list. So this is extremely helpful when it comes to making sure you just want to look at one specific product within your product offerings. However, if you wanted to look at all products all together, you can just go into your drop-down list and select all products. All right, so let's focus on the next step. You need to adjust the countries on the sheets by country, by product and country, and monthly phasing. What do I mean by that? Again, you are getting a pre-filled data pool. So that means all of these countries over here might not necessarily be relevant to your business. It could be that you're not operating in Spain or France. It could be you're just focusing on, let's say, 1, 2, maybe 3 countries. So what you can do by that, in order to change this template, is you can delete countries altogether. So I would go ahead and just, you know, delete this column completely. Or let's say if I wanted, if I have 19 countries that I operate in, I would want to change individual names here, right? So if I wanted to change Germany to, let's say, Taiwan, of course, now this is not giving me any data. Why? Because this is not reflected in my data pool. I don't have Taiwan in my data over here. But if I quickly change, you know, one of them to Taiwan, go back to the country, and since we changed January, let's see. Yes, you see, now I get some data in here. So generally speaking, you want to make sure that this pre-filled template is tailored to your individual needs. And of course, anything you change in here, in terms of the countries, also in terms of revenue, the COGS, SG&A expenses, also needs to be changed in the data tab. So what do we need to do in here within the data tab? Again, this is pre-filled and it has a lot of data in it. This is just to give you an indication as to what is really possible. Let's say we want to again focus on the profitability. Profitability starts off with revenue. So you want to make sure that this column D is maintained and you enter the respective revenue for your country and the month. You also add in the COGS and then the administrative expenses. Now, knowing the nature of them, there could be various kind of things. It could be personnel costs. It could be travel expenses. It could be other administrative fees. So what I did here is I gave you some room to filter for these different expenses. However, these three columns will all roll up into admin expenses right here. You see, this is a sum. So what you want to do in this template is first, get rid of all the rows that you don't need. If you only, let's say, have about 30 different expense categories or revenue data, then you can delete the entire rest down below. Once you've updated all this, make sure that the formulas you've put, meaning over here in column I and J, are dragged down all the way to the end. That way, you can ensure that all of these formulas will be picked up in the different data tables. So if you need more columns for admin expenses, which will later roll up into column I, I suggest you add them in between already existing columns. What do I mean by that? So again, let's look at column I here. You know, it focuses on these three columns, F until H. And let's say I want to add an additional column for the admin expenses. Now, in order for this additional column to be reflected right away in my admin expense total, I suggest we add them in between existing ones. So that could be either between 1 and 2 or 2 and 3. Do not add them at the borders. Always add them in between, because that would mean your formula will automatically be extended. You see? So now I can go ahead and enter new admin expenses or whatever I want to add in here. This is just one side note, which is going to make your life a lot easier. Now, maybe in the last step, let's take a look at some of the functionalities that this template really features. First of all, we've already seen the by country view. Essentially, our business is operating in 19 different countries, and we're saying we're looking at revenue, COGS, we got the gross profit margin, we got selling and general and administrative expenses, which in the end lead up to the EBIT. We also have an overview on the quarterly performance of the gross profit as well as the EBIT result. We can go ahead and change the selections on the months, meaning, for example, May, or we could also change the view from a month-to-date to a year-to-date perspective. Month-to-date meaning we would only be looking at the month of May as such, and if we select year-to-date, that would mean we would look at Jan, Feb, March, April, and May included, so 5 months in total. Now, we have the same kind of view on a separate sheet, which also allows us to dig in a bit deeper. Because here, on top of just selecting months and the view, we can also change the view on the products. And again, this all refers to drop-down lists that you have defined in the mapping table. Now, in the last step, what may sometimes be interesting is to look at the monthly phasing. What I mean by that is we can look at monthly revenue, the breakdown by country. The same holds true for the COGS and SG&A expenses. And what's really interesting to look at is what's the percentage that the month of January for Belgium makes up in terms of the total revenue for the entire company. And this you can see right down below. If you want to hide these, you can just close the groupings and you just see the totals over here. Of course, you can also go ahead and change the product selections. And overall, you have a lot of flexibility to perform your analysis. So this is it. This is the introduction to the profitability dashboard. And I hope that this has been helpful in understanding how you can customize this template to your individual needs.